Hi guys, this is Daniel from F&D. In this video, I'm going to show you the free alternative for Midjourney. We already know that Midjourney is the paid AI generating platform. In this video, we are going to see the free alternative for that Midjourney. So let's get started. So this website is called playgroundai.com. Here you can generate thousands of images per day for free, and you can also use it for commercial purpose also. So you can see that, you can see the pricing. In the free, you can see you can create up to 1000 images per day, and you can also use it for commercial purpose. And next one is the pro. In pro version, you can generate 2000 images, and for additional $10, you can add on DALL-E 2. You can generate images using DALL-E. Let's see how this Playground AI works. Go to playgroundai.com. The link is in the description. You can sign up using your Google account. If you already have your account, you can sign in. After signing in, you will get this community feed. So you can see different users creating images using this Playground AI. So you can also use this as your reference. To create AI generated images, click on the down arrow near the create and select on your board. If you need, you can watch this tutorial as well. So you can see the UI over here. On the left hand side, you have filters, prompts, and you can also have negative prompts, and you can also generate image to image. So on the right side, you can change models. Right now we have Playground, Stable Diffusion 1.5, Stable Diffusion 2.1 and DALL-E 2. DALL-E 2 works only on paid version, and you can change the image dimension as well. So you can also buy a pro plan, and you can increase the height up to 1536 pixels. So you have prompt guidance, quality, you can adjust the seed, and you can generate a number of images. So I'm going to give the 4, and you can also click on here to make this session private. So let's see how to generate AI images using this. So we need to type a prompt. Before that, I'm gonna make the filter to none, and I'm gonna type a simple prompt, cat, 8K, and generate. So you can see the model is 1.5. You can see the generated images, and using the same prompt, we can add some filters that is given by a Playground. Let's select this dream shaper filter and click on generate. So you can see the difference between this one and this one. Also try different filters. Let's try this playtone filter. So click on generate. For each filter, you can see additional prompts are added. For this playtone, you can see the additional prompts, playtone style, cat, and 8K is given by me. And you can see the cute, big, circular, reflective eyes, a Pixar render, Unreal Engine are given by this Playground AI. So you can see the difference. So this again I generated without any filter. If you want to exclude something from the image, for example, you don't need a brown color cat, you can add brown color. Click on generate. You can see the cat is now in gray color. So let's see brown color. Also, I'm going to give gray color. So this one giving gray color, but most of the cats are in different color. This one giving orange color. This one also. Now I added whiskers in exclude from image. You can see the results. This one doesn't have the whiskers. You get my point, but this one has whiskers. So some images has whiskers and some don't. So you get my point that if you want to remove something from the image, you can use this negative prompt. And here you can see the image to image. You can add images as your reference, and you can set the image strength and type in your prompt, and it will give the results. Let's try that. So I'm going to give the image strength as default as 30. Now I'm going to add a prompt. Viking standing near the lake. click on generate. So you can see the results. Results are not looking great, but you get my point. It is using this reference image. From that reference image, it is generating this AI generated images. So if we increase the strength, it will use more of this reference image. So let's try the 70. So you can see it is looking more like the reference image. So you can also add the filters for this. So I'm gonna try this realistic vision and reduce the image strength to 30. So remove this negative prompt. So let's try. Click on generate. So you can see some different images are created. And you can also choose different models. And on the right hand side top, you will get different models. Click on this drop down. And you can see four different models: Playground version 1, Stable Diffusion 1.5, Stable Diffusion 2.1, and DALL-E 2. Let's try Playground V1. And for Playground V1, we have these set of filters, not much compared to Stable Diffusion 1.5. For Stable Diffusion 1.5, you can see there are more different filters available. So for Playground V1, you have these different filters. And for Stable Diffusion 2.1, you have only these two filters. And for DALL-E 2, you need to purchase the DALL-E 2 add-on. So let's try using Playground version 1. I'm using the same cat, 8K prompt. So you can see this prompt giving this results. So you can also change the dimensions. You can have the square dimension, 512 by 512, 1024 by 1024. And also the horizontal orientation sizes, 640 by 384, and vertical dimensions. So let's try this vertical dimension. I'm going to use the same prompt again. I'm going to click on generate. So you can see the dimensions. Sorry, this one is a horizontal dimension. Let's try the vertical one. So this one is a vertical dimension. Let's generate. So you can see the vertical dimension results. So next one is the prompt guidance. You can see it is saying higher values will make your image closer to your prompt. So if we increase the value to 30, it will give the result close to the prompt. For example, if you are giving more prompts and you are giving the prompt guidance as 30, the AI will give the result close to the prompt. If we give the value like something like 7, have more creative access, and it will give image less closer to the prompt. And it is recommended to have 7 to 10 prompt guidance. So I'm going to stick with 7. And next is the quality and detail. So you can see more step will result in high quality image, but it will take a longer time. So if we increase to 150, it will have more quality and more detail, but it will take longer time. So you can see the recommended value is 50. So I'm going to keep it as 50. Next one is seed. So for example, here you can see the random seed. And I'm going to use the same prompt. Click on generate. You can see the results giving the same image. So if we change the seed value, I'm going to change the last two digit to 99. Let's generate. We will get different image. You can see that the different cat image is generated. So you can also randomize each number to get new variation. But if we select a number of images to 4, it will automatically grayed out. So if we select one image, you can add a seed value, and also you can randomize each number to get new variation. Let's try randomize, generate, and you will get a different result. You can see that. And the next one is click on show advanced options, and you can see the sampler. You can see the diffusion sampler. So for Stable Diffusion 1.5, we try different samplers. So these are the available samplers. I mostly use this one, Ancestral K Euler Ancestral. So I don't know how to pronounce that. So this is the one I mostly use. Most of them are using this sampler. So you can use this sampler. So you can try different samplers. So let's try that. So using the same seed, let's generate one with this sampler. So you can see sometime it will create images like this. You can exclude that from using the exclude from image negative prompts. You can search online to get the negative prompts template. You can copy that and paste it over here, and you can avoid some images like double faces, distorted hands, something like that. So try a different seed. So using this 816 seed and using sampler Euler Ancestral, we get this image. Let's try different sampler. Let's try this PNDM and generate. You will get some different results. So you can see this result. You can try different sampler and select which one suits for you. So let's try DDIM. You can see the result, which are pretty much similar to this one. So this area, you have more furs and you have minimal furs. So next one is, we already see that you can select the number of images to generate. If you click this one, and this seed option will grade out. So let's try this. Four images. You can try three images. Let's try three. Click on generate. So you can see the results. So this is the very basic tutorial on how to use Playground AI. In future videos, I will upload in-depth tutorial on how to create very good images using this Playground AI. So if you don't know what to add in the prompt, you can definitely use this community feed. So on the top, you have community feed. I'm going to open in new tab. So find which one you like. For example, I like this one. Click on that and you can copy the prompts. Paste it on the prompt section, and you can copy this negative prompts as well. Copy that and paste. You can also see the seed value. You can use the same seed value, and you can see the filter style. This one is the Dream Shaper filter. So I'm going to change to, where is Dream Shaper? Dream Shaper. And also you can see the sampler. So I'm going to change to that sampler. And this one is Stable Diffusion 1.5 model. So I'm going to change it to Stable Diffusion 1.5. So now you can adjust the prompts. Instead of Firefox, I'm type in Fire Phoenix. So I'm going to remove this prompt Fox ears. So I'm going to leave all other as it is. Let's generate. So you can see the result. It is giving a good AI generated images. So if you don't know what to type in the prompt, you can definitely use the community feed, and you can mildly change the prompt and generate your images. To download this, you can directly click on download, or if you want to create variations, you can definitely click on this to create more variations from this image. And if you want to edit in Canvas, I'm going to do that in a separate video. You can click on this. So next, you can also click on actions, and you can use in image to image. If we click on image to image, it will bring that image over here. And from that image, you can add again prompts. using that image as a reference. So if you want to download this image, before clicking on this download icon, you need to upscale it by 4x. Then click on download. And it will automatically download it to your PC. If you want to see all the generated images, you can go to your profile, click on here and click on profile. You can see the all the images you have generated. Here you can delete it to make your profile clean. And here you can also click on the image to see what prompt we have given. So you can see this is the prompt, and you can copy the prompt. You can remix as well. You can see the seed, sampler, then the guidance value, etc. So you can also download from here. Also, you can upscale by 4x. You can also make it to public as well. So that's it, guys. This is the free alternative for Midjourney called Playground AI. Here you can generate thousands of images per day for free, and you can also use it for commercial purpose as well. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, give thumbs up, subscribe to the channel for more future tutorials on this Playground AI. Also press the bell icon so that you can get instant notification when I upload a video. Thanks for watching and bye.